بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد سيد الأولين والآخرين. السلام عليكم everybody. We now pick up where we left off reading from the book عقيدة العوام of Imam al-Marzuqi, and right here he starts the second line and he says فالحمد لله القديم الأول الآخر الباقي بلا تحول. He says then all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right? And again, the idea of emulating the Quran, right? So the first line begins by, you know, invoking Bismillahi, right? Like Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And then here saying Alhamdulillahi, right? Is like Surah Al-Fatiha. So that's really cool. Our scholars actually embodied the Quran in words and deeds. And of course, we know that praising Allah, Alhamdulillah, is really Miftahul Khayri Kulli, is one of the keys to opening great relationships with our Lord and bringing out blessings and barakah. Allah says in the Quran, if you thank me, I increase you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But he says, فَالْحَمْدُلِلَّهِ الْقَدِيمِ الْأَوَّلِ. I want you to pay attention to these words, al-qadim and al-awwal. They're actually synonyms. Al-akhiri, al-baqi, bila tahawwali. And these two that I just underlined, al-akhir and al-baqi, are also synonyms. But something's going on here. The Sheikh is alluding to something very important, and we talked about it in our last brief time together, and that is that al-qadim actually is the terminology of the scholars of kalam, right? The scholars of theology. And al-awwal and al-akhir and al-baqi are of course found in the Quran and used in the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ and used by scholars of hadith. But what he's trying to show here is that sometimes scholars may use different words to describe these attributes, right? And use qualities to describe them. And that is not something that we should be arguing over or fighting over. Hence, remember that axiom I talked about last time? La mushahata fi istilah. I really want you to learn this axiom, man. There's no disputing or no disputes over terms. And he starts this way as if to say, listen, my approach is going to be the approach of the majority, which was the scholars of kalam. The reason that it was called kalam is because kalam means to talk a lot, right? Kalam actually means speech. So the idea was that people talk about God so much, it's called ilmu kalam. And that's really cool, right? It runs contrary to the notion that like Islam or even modern religion, people, the assumptions about religion is like, religion doesn't ask us to talk about God or encourage us to ask questions. Man, the name of our theology is Ilmul Kalam because people talk about it so much and people are encouraged to talk about it. SubhanAllah, just an FYI. But the point is, he begins by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then recognizing, mashallah ta'ala, these names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he alludes right here to the fact that he's going to be teaching those qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then at the end, he mentions Allah's transcendence, bila tahawwuli, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not change, right? His beginning, his ending is transcendent. His existence is transcendent. He's not affected by getting tired. He doesn't take a day off. We're going to talk about that more in the future, inshallah. So what do you want to take from this line? You want to take the vocabulary, al-qadim, al-awwal, al-akhir, al-baqi, tahawwul, and then you want to take away this axiom that there's la mushahata fi istilah. We don't argue and fight over terms. I really, really hope that people can digest that, live it, and become really catalyst for unity in the Muslim community. Barakallahu feekum wa sallallahu ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.